Julia comes with a REPL that helps us use the language dynamically. So if I start Julia from the command line here, we enter what we call the REPL mode. And REPL means read, evaluate, print, and loop. And basically what it does, for example here, when I type A equals 1 and I press enter, is read the instruction A equals 1, evaluate the instruction, and print back the output, which is 1 here. And then it gets ready for the next command, for example, B equals 2, and it loops again, read, eval, print. And if we don't want to print the output back to the terminal, what we can do is add a semicolon at the end. The Julia REPL offers several modes. So for example, here we're in the standard REPL mode for Julia, but we can also switch to the documentation mode by inputting a question mark like this. And here we can type the name of function, for example, sum, and press enter, and it will search for the documentation for this function here. Then we have the package manager mode by pressing the closing square bracket like this. And here we can also get the documentation for the package manager by again pressing question mark. Packages are portions of relatively generic code that are shared by the community, and you can install those packages using the package manager. So basically the package manager helps you install but also update and remove those packages, and it also helps you to set up a Julia environment, but we will make a whole video about that. So the basics of the package manager are to add a package. So to add a package, you can use the add function. So for example, if we want to add the plots package, we would do that and press enter. And what it does is going online to the Julia registry, checking if the package exists, and then download it and install it on your environment. And you can check which packages are installed on your environment by using the status function. Here I can see all the packages I have installed, and I can also remove a package using the remove function. And if I want the status back, I can see here that the plot package was removed. We can also check the status of one particular package. So for example, I see that I have the CSV package, and if I want more details about this package, I can type status CSV. We can also update the packages using the update function. So just update will update all the packages and their dependencies. But if we want to update just one package, we just have to put his name after the update command. So here it will go to the registry, check my version and the last version deployed on the registry. And if the last version on the registry is newer than mine, it will update the package and all its dependencies. So I think this is it for the basics of the package manager. But if you want more details, I'll make a future video about all the features of the package manager and about Julia environments. To quit the package manager mode, the only thing you have to do is to press the backspace key, just like this. And the last mode I wanted to show you is the shell mode. And to enter it, you just have to press the semicolon key, just like this. And here you are in the shell mode. And before ending the video, I wanted to show you some tips and tricks about the Julia REPL. So for example, to clean the terminal, you can just press Ctrl and L at the same time. Another interesting thing is the ends variable, and it binds to the last result returned by Julia. So for example, if we type A equals 1, the last value is 1, right? So the ends value is also 1. One of the most useful tools is tab autocompletion. So for example, if I have a very long variable name, my variable name, for example, equals 1. Well, if I want to use this variable, but I don't want to type the whole long name, I can just type the first letters of the name and use tab, the tab key, to autocomplete for the name. And now I can use it, for example, multiply by 2. And if I have several variables that start with the same name, for example, well, autocompletion still works. I can use tab here and it will autocomplete until the variable's name change. And if I press tab again, it will show me all the variables I can access with the my var. So here I have to type the rest. to access the variable. And it works with functions too. So for example, if I want to use the square root function, but I don't remember quite how it's spelled, well, I can just type SQ and using tab, and it will autocomplete for me. And also, what is nice is that if I want to use the square root on, say, a float, for example, so 1.0, and I don't know if there are optional arguments that come after the first argument, after my float, well, I can put a comma and use tab to list all the methods that are implemented with a first argument as a float. If you feel a bit lost at this time because of all the details like floats, methods, etc., no worries, we don't need this at this time, and we will go into such details in further videos in the future. One interesting thing also is that you can navigate on your code, on your previous code that you executed, using the up and down arrows. So if I press the up arrow, I will get the last line I just executed, and if I continue to press up, I will get all the lines I executed, and if I press the down arrow, I can navigate. We can also search for previous code by pressing Ctrl and R, and here it's in reverse iSearch, so I can type, for example, my var, and it will search for the last thing that match my VA here, which is my var1, and I can navigate on previous code by pressing Ctrl R. So this is reverse search, and forward search is by pressing Ctrl S. So I can navigate with Ctrl S and Ctrl R. To quit this mode, I just have to press Escape. And the last thing I wanted to talk about is that we can use LaTeX-like names in Julia. So for example, just by escaping the name, I can write pi, and by using tab, the autocompletion key, I have pi. And if I execute this character, the value is pi. And we can also use like this the square root. So it's escaping sqrt. And if I press tab, I have the square root, and it works. If I want the square root of 4, for example, I get 2. And we can even have more complex variable names like x with a subscript of 1. And if I autocomplete, I have this character, and I can use it as a variable name, and it's functional like this. And to have a superscript, I just have to type it like this and tab, and it autocompletes, and I can use it like this. So it's really useful for mathematicians, for example, or physicians. So I think this is it for the first tour of the Julia REPL. If you have any questions, please ask them in the comments. This video is part of a playlist, so if you're interested in Julia development, you can follow all the videos I make in order from that playlist. Thank you for watching, and I see you next time.